Hey everybody, welcome back to Wine Up TV. I'm your host Wayne with Scott Henry, and the fourth. When we come back, Southern Oregon Wines, his new label, is going to tell you all about them. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Scott, the fourth.
How are you, Wayne?
I'm doing well, man. So you're up here for the Wine Symposium.
I am.
And that was a couple days ago, which is cool. And you have your own wine now on the market with your own label in a sea of wine. You've kind of branched out and started doing your own thing, didn't you?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Well, spent a lot of years in the Umpqua Valley making Umpqua Valley wines.
Were you born
for
there?
A family. No, I was actually born in Sacramento. Okay. Spent half my childhood there, but grew up in the wine industry since the late 70s, all through the early 80s and the development of it. Opportunity for my wife and I to start our own, you know, project, as we refer to it, and a concept that we've been bouncing around for a long time, Seasoned Cellars.
All right, Seasoned Cellars. Very cool. This is their label. And you have your first two wines here. You're doing a Syrah and also a
Viognier.
A Viognier, right. Which are pretty standard, the varietals down in Southern Oregon. It's warmer.
Yes.
You know, as opposed to up here in the Northern Willamette Valley, where you might get Viognier to ripen in 2005. You know, but not in a cooler vintage. All right, so Seasoned Cellars, small production, starting off. This first wine, this is kind of fun. I remember, and this is the they call it Transparency, 2012. What I like about it is this reminds me of drinking wine in my early years when I was in my 20s.
Uh-huh.
The grape varietals, Müller Thurgau, Riesling, and
Muscat.
A little Muscat.
Yes.
But what's nice about this wine is, we'll do this one first, even though it's a little, you can talk about this.
Okay.
It's a little Frizzante.
It is. We like the way that the bubbles work with the fruit, helps lift the fruit off the tongue. It's a fun, you know, and all the seriousness that we need to do and revolve around the wines, we also want to have fun with some of them too. We wanted to make the very funnest, best sweet wine that we could, enhancing aromatics with the muscat, the pineapple and honey from the Müller Thurgau, and bringing a little fresher, cleaner balance into those two varietals with the Riesling. The three grape wines we know are wonderful solo singers on their own. We wanted to see if we could bring the three together and see if they could sing harmoniously as well. And
they're singing. So,
yeah, well, we wanted to do kind of the Crosby, Stills, and Nash thing here and actually see if we could get them to harmonize very well together.
I wish Young could come back, though, because Young really kind of made that whole.
So, and then when we came up with, you know, this it kind of a proprietary or a fanciful name, then we kind of extended that, wrote the description kind of in a poem form.
How'd you come up with Transparency?
My wife Jennifer actually came up with a name. Müller Thurgau and Muscat and Riesling, when it's real young, always have a very clear, almost look like water in the glass. And it's always fun when you pour those and people are like looking and then they, oh wow, it doesn't smell or taste like water, obviously. So
I like the name.
The name came up, and not only just describing the wine, but kind of a way of life, transparency. Everything's out, everything we do and everything we've done is right, you know, right here. You can see it all.
These are spot on too, because you know, with Müller Thurgau and with Muscat, Müller Thurgau for the aromatics, the Muscat for the tropical, mango almost flavors, and of course a
peach.
Little bit a little
peach.
A
white peach out
of it. And then the Riesling's in there just because it's a pretty good backbone for everything.
I think that's right, bringing in some acidity, some natural balance.
So retail you're looking about 18 bucks,
$18,
about $18 right for that wine.
Yeah,
very nice. All right, so let's talk about this wine, which you don't see too much 100% varietal. Well, this isn't 100% varietal.
It's actually 12.5% Cabernet Sauvignon, 87.5% Malbec. Southern Oregon Malbec is poised to explode. It's just becoming known out there. There's some from Washington, and we're seeing a little bit from California, but I think it's going to be the next American Merlot.
Don't say that. I don't like Merlot.
I don't like Merlot that much either. That's why we love Malbec. It's more giving in the nose and in the mouth of both fruit. And the roundness and the fruity, I think everybody come to look, you know, to Merlot for. Red berry and Merlot. This is all about blackberry. Blackberry and Marionberry. Kind of violets in the nose.
A little coffee, a little chocolate on it, too.
Could be little notes of that in there. But the predominant fruit to us is Marion, almost like Marionberry pie in the finish. And it just lays on the palate continuously with this blackberry fruit.
So what kind of acreage is planted Malbec-wise in Southern Oregon?
I think there's only less than 200, 150 acres. That's probably,
not
and not very much at all.
And you're harvesting this about, what, 3 tons of fruit per acre?
Two. Yeah, most that's of this was Pino. Harvested in the 2 ton per acre range, yeah.
So that's not much wine. I mean, and you have other players down there, you know, buying up a lot of that fruit. So, you know, this is a very, very nice Malbec. Retail, about $27, $28, $29. You know, Malbec, since they don't make a lot of it down there, it's going to be a little bit more expensive. I think it's one of those wines that are going to be a little coveted. The 2011 vintage wasn't that warm even down there, you know, let alone up here in the Willamette Valley. But it's not as acidic as I would have thought it to be.
13.5 alcohol.
What's the alcohol on this wine?
That one's 10.5. The transparency is intended to be very low alcohol, very lightweight, and very clean in the mouth.
Chick wines.
You're
drinking if you're going to get naked fast.
Well, that's possible too. That makes it guy wines too, right? Because the guys want to be around when that happens,
yeah,
right? So they might be. I think the guys might be drinking some of it too.
There, cold will just fall off.
Actually, the Miller Turk or the Transparency is a stepping stone wine. It's a wine that we would pour if I had somebody come in the tasting room or the wine shop environment and said, I don't like wine, I like beer. We hear that, you know, and I'm a beer drinker too. I like microbrews, but it's the Transparency that we want to pour for them because they're looking for something a little simpler, lighter, fruity, just easy to, you know, grasp and appreciate.
Okay, I'll throw it down. This is a great picnic wine. It's a great warm weather wine.
Summer sipper.
It really is. Come wintertime, you know, even my rosé sales in the summer or in the wintertime, and some of my white wine sales, depends on what white wine people are looking for, they really kind of fall off. Once it gets cold, it's hard to sell a summertime wine. I always consider these summertime wines.
Yes.
And what's nice about where you live in Southern Oregon, summer starts earlier and it lasts later than it does up here.
That's right.
It does up here. I mean, here, you know, I mean, 2011 with 4 ripe tomatoes all summer long. You know, and 2000 last year, man, I had ripe tomatoes like mid-July. End of July was great. So you just never know. All right. So, guys, if you ever want to go down there, when are you going to be opening up a tasting room?
Well, we're working on that. We're producing the wines at the Wild Rose Vineyard location.
Okay.
He's our host winery
of
Wild Rose Studios. We hope to have things in place to open in April.
Very cool.
We haven't completely put all that together.
I wish you the best of luck.
Very good. Thank you,
Wayne. Thank you very much for coming.
Appreciate you having me here,
guys,
today.
Thank you very much. Check out these wines. They're kind of hard to find. They're not really in the market yet. But I'm sure I can call Henry and he'll get you some. See you later.